Former Superintendent Jim Keogh spearheaded the assault on outlaw motorcycle gangs. But while police won the war, the battle, it seems, is only getting started.
But the reality is we are confronted with a gangland-style execution in suburbia.
Monday's slaying of notorious bikie Shane Bowden is reigniting calls for tougher laws and more police.
One of the main laws there, of course, was groups of three. You were arrestable. They were arrestable offences on the spot.
The former top cop believes there simply isn't enough police dedicated to bikies. He says there needs to be at least 100 on the job.
You must commit to the war 24/7 here on the Gold Coast, or it will take over.
Well, when Jim Keogh speaks, we need to listen.
While police wage a war of their own, the state political battlefield isn't letting up.
And today, Maxima on the Gold Coast is operating with 6 staff.
But the government isn't buying it, insisting plans in place are working.
The track record shows that the laws are working, that they're being used by police, that police are getting arrests, and that significant penalties are being dished out.
Meanwhile, a national police operation targeting members and associates of the Hells Angels outlaw motorcycle gang has led to the arrests of 24 people. While on the Gold Coast today, 3 Mongols bikies were arrested. 2 of them are facing drug and trafficking charges.
Police say those arrests aren't linked to Monday's shooting. Jacob Chico for 10 News First.